I'm growing on her.
Like a fungus, Safe.
It wasn't me. Dead Lucy. Wife finds a strange earring in bed. Husband blames Lucy. Never had a murder pinned on her, though.
And the killer, who could be closer than I'd like to think. Ace puts up the slacker front, but he's smarter than he seems.
I got big news.
Even if he's
gonna let a ghost story stop us from our one chance of gathering this evidence. So we're gonna work together to break into the morgue tonight. Wait, all we need is Ryan's phone.
That's definitely not what I said. Well, so forget I mentioned it. It's a moment of weakness.
Just keep telling yourself that.
She said motive. Something about his juvenile conviction.
It's Ace. He says he needs my help.
Hey.
Hi. Thanks for coming. I just didn't want to embarrass her.
I'll take it from here.
Mm-hmm.
What kind of supernatural thing could make her act like that?
Did something go wrong with the ritual? Bess filled me in on what you guys did at the funeral. We're platankers now, so she tells when you're not around.
What could have gone wrong? But she returned the ring, Tiffany's coffin went into the ground, and... Come, Mom.
What are you doing?
Okay, let's just go with the idea for a second that this is Tiffany.
So you want to show her she is George? Bad news, Tiffany doesn't like you. Tiffany's dead, so... The other bad news is that Tiffany's spirit has been hitching a ride in your body. Intermittently.
Like it was for your last date?
Fine, but if anything happens to you, you're not my...
But now we know there's more to it. Her death is linked to Tiffany's. That's what she was trying to tell me at the Velvet Mask. We have to solve Lucy's murder in order to solve Tiffany's.
Yeah, but how are the two murders linked?
They both learned things about the Hudsons that could have gotten them killed. Tiffany found out about the Hudsons sinking the Bonnie Scott and the coins we stole at the Velvet Mask. Luckily, the coins prove what they did.
And Lucy found out that Celia Hudson was having an affair with her husband's business rival. And then less than a year later, she was murdered.
Hey, I can't talk right now. This is a bad time. I'm in the middle of something.
Too bad. I didn't make a deal for silence.
Really? You hacked into the Horseshoe Bay Digital Library?
Sort of. I used my library card.
Why are we hacking into the library?
How pissed do you think McGinnis is gonna be when he sees that?
Oh my God.
Hey, I have a new theory for you.
I have a theory, too. I think you're working for McGinnis. You were the only one that he didn't bring in for questioning the night Tiffany died. When you saw you together at the funeral? What were you guys talking about? You've been cagey on the phone and then running off to who knows where. You heard my phone call with John Sander, and less than an hour later, McGinnis is talking to me about poison.
It's not like that. A year ago, McGinnis caught me hacking into a government computer system, which is a federal offense.
Why would you?
The point is, I thought my life was over, but he offered me this deal. He'd make sure that I stay out of jail, and all I had to do was look into a few things for him and keep my eyes open around town, which was easy enough until Tiffany got murdered.
You could have told us.
That would have violated the deal. I can't go to jail. Listen, I'm sorry. I'm not trying to make excuses. I messed up. But will you at least let me try to make it up to you? I learned something about Laura.
How am I supposed to trust anything you say?
I'm gonna fix this.
Hey, I tried calling.
George, this is not a good time.
There was an accident. It was Ace.
Hi.
I'm really sorry.
No, I'm sorry. How are you?
I have to take this. Okay, come on, Drew. A quick search is not gonna get anyone hurt.
What are you doing?
Nothing.
Why are you looking at a picture of my dad?
Hey, you know, what if we just told the cops? Your dad worked on a case in 2003 that had the same poison that killed Tiffany.
You stole Tiffany's blood to get these test results. I think admitting to that right before your arraignment's less than advisable. Now, before you meet the captain...
You call your dad the captain?
Here's a few things you should know. He doesn't like people much. He lost his hearing after his accident on the force, so he can read your lips, but a little self-conscious about speaking. And fair warning, my house can be a bit of a war zone.
Yeah, I can tell.
No. I wanted you to meet somebody.
Captain Tom? I'm Nancy Drew.
The hero of Horseshoe Bay. Yes, the one and only. She wanted to ask you something about Liza Ainslie. It's a suicide case in 2003. Do you remember her? With a vial of poison.
Was killed by the same rare poison. I don't know who waits 15 years between kills, but...
And one more the year after that.
That has to be a cipher, right? Can we try decoding it? Together? Ace, did you learn anything from the obits?
Yeah. Life's short. I know. That's what I'm doing.
Photo quality is terrible. Unless maybe the clue isn't this.
Hey, you okay? They never wanted you to figure out the name. They wanted you to focus on the bogus site.
You didn't figure it out then. But we figured it out now. There's time to make it right.
From over a decade ago, we don't know the names or even if they're connected.
Well, maybe they are connected. That's why the killer engaged with you. So it's time for a Hail Mary. Here, record this.
Record what?
Just record me. I'm gonna upload this to my fan page. I believe there is a serial poisoner operating in our town, and I have a message for them. I cracked your cipher. You want to play a game? Fine, let's play. But I'm changing the rules. I'm giving you the name of your next victim.
Ace, you said you put the obituaries in my bag, but they're not there. They're here.
Now we can get started. Did you find the names of the other victims in the emails that my dad got?
I don't need your help.
Did the killer contact you? What did the cipher say? Are they coming for you?
No.
We need to figure out how the other victims are related. Do you have their names from the ciphers in the emails?
Bridget and Pam.
Bridget and Pam.
You don't have to
shut up.
Pam was a proud alum of Hawthorne High School.
Wait,
Closed down in like 2004.
Hey, Bridget Wishbow. She was the assistant.
Okay, what about Liza? Did she have a connection?
So she definitely wasn't Tiffany's killer.
No. We're getting close, though. We know that it's the same poison that killed Tiffany. We now know that it's very hard to make. And there's an antidote.
Night.
Good night, Ace.
Nancy, I know you're in the middle of a thing, but I really need you to call me back. But the thing is that your dad is in trouble, and there's no time to wait. I'm sure, you know, it's gonna be okay. Unless it isn't, but it is. It's gonna be, good. Just call me back whenever you get a chance.
There she is.
How you doing, Ace?
How you doing? Bess's Instagram's been blowing up.
Hey.
Now what? Pulse is steady, but it's really weak. We need to find a crash cart. Come on.
I'll help.
Come on. Let's go.
Ace, that is not the answer, okay? There must be something else we can do.
We can talk to her. Like you guys did with me when I was in the coma after the car accident. Weird being back in Kansas again.
Dorothy never had to deal with an ex. Yeah. Especially when they're doing much better without you.
Hey, if you are going home, one other thing happened while you were on your head trip.
Because I think I'm doing your job, Karen. I'm trying to find out who actually killed Lucy.
It's a great segue, Anthony. Oh. But you have access to Tiffany Hudson's phone GPS information, right?
What? We always said Lucy's case file didn't have the answers to what happened, so we're trying a new angle.
Hey, so before you move to Paris, will you go with me to La Bibliothèque?
Mr. and Mrs. Neff, good to see you. The regulars.
And you, as a character in a Victorian novel, spend all of your free time in the library?
Kinda. My mom works here.
But she's not in today.
Your help, specifically. Dominique, we need the help of a staff member generally. I didn't study coding like some people. Some of us are just naturally gifted, self-taught.
So that's a no.
Just show me. We can follow Tiffany's trail because a few years ago, a wily teenager installed keystroke logging software on every computer in the library.
And you did that why?
Okay.
Got it. Tiffany was looking at an old Quicksnail account, specifically this email chain.
Oh my God, there are love letters between Lucy Sable and Ryan Hudson from December 1999 to April 2000.
Wow.
I've never felt like this before. I think I love you.
I think I love you too. I want to be with you. I don't care what anyone else says.
The last email between them, Lucy sent. Please forgive me. Forgive her for what?
Hold on. There's a response to that email that was deleted on Ryan's end.
Can we find it?
Can if we hack Lucy's side. And now I know her email.
How long do you think that's gonna take?
We're in. It's an old account on an old server, but if Dominique asks, it was really difficult. And that was amazing.
Do you think we could find out where Lucy was sending those emails from?
The Sables weren't wealthy, so I don't think that they had internet access at home in 2000.
Yeah, I can trace her IP address. In the meantime, I found what Ryan sent Lucy. Here's your deleted email.
I can't forgive you for what you did. You're a whore, just like everyone says. I hope you die.
There's nothing else sent to Ryan's Quicksnail account.
He went to boarding school then.
In August, Lucy sent Ryan an email to his Eddings Hall account. I know you're still angry, but I need to talk to you. Meet me the night of the Sea Queen ceremony at our spot. And Ryan replied, I'll be there.
They arranged to meet the night that Lucy was killed.
Order, and I brought them to Ace.
What happened next?
You all right?
What are you working on? Is this the...
As you requested, I'm searching for the GPS coordinates of the IP address. Lucy used to email Ryan.
Ace!
Thanks, Ace.
I need your help!
I'm fine.
Hey, do you have the copies of Ryan's emails to Lucy?
Mm-hmm. In my car.
This is Claire Barnett's poison.
The vial's full.
Brand new. There's no way that it's from Liza's case 15 years ago. The original vial got swapped out for a decoy. Nancy.
Hey. Detective Hart.
That's police evidence.
Okay, everybody just be cool.
This isn't Claire's poison.
What?
You're trespassing.
And I saw your signature on the work order for the refrigerator repair. That's when I realized it was you who swapped out the poisons. Because you don't have to take AP Chem to know that in a glass container, the meniscus of a liquid containing poison, like Baneberry, curves downward, but this meniscus curves upward because it's just water, right?
No. What are you?
You leave me no choice. I'm arresting you for breaking and entering and trespassing.
Do not tampering with police. Let her do this. She's gonna get us out of here and then destroy the vial, and no one will ever know the truth. Karen gave the poison to Josh.
Yeah, they will.
Hey, Ace! You okay?
Just water. Neither. I know Nancy. I knew she was right. Hi. Nancy, how are you doing?
In Ryan's emails to Lucy, he used single spaces after the periods, but in the last email where he called her a whore, he uses double spaces.
You think he didn't write that one?
Can you track the IP address to see where it was sent from?
Yeah. Give me 2 minutes.
Lucy never wanted me to figure out how she died.
Yeah, I get that. Maybe she carried the trauma of her suicide over into her death.
But then why is she haunting me? Why the bones? What does she want me to solve? Hey.
Hey.
Hello?
So?
Just finishing what we started.
Anything?
I'm getting there.
Okay.
Get in.
I know you're dealing with a lot, but Victoria says the Aglaika's coming after us.
Nick, Bess, George, you've all gotten these really weird visions.
Portents? Have you?
I vomited up the seaweed wreath yesterday morning.
I would say that qualifies.
When I went to look for it later, it had turned to sand. You saying the Aglaika did that?
Yeah. Apparently it's like a bloodhound. And because it responded to your call for Lucy's bones, you're acting as its gateway.
But that also means that you're the one who's capable of stopping it.
Okay, how?
Well, Victoria says that you can throw it off your trail by mixing your blood with somebody else's, disguising yourself, so that, you know, the curse can't find you, because if it can't find you, can't find any of us. But the ritual has to be done with a relative, your blood relative.
Well, that's a problem, because you saw the test results last night. My closest relative is not my blood relative.
Ryan Hudson is. Well, I know that poses certain challenges, and don't worry, I'm gonna keep that part confidential, but...
I think I have a plan. I'll meet you guys at Diana Marvin's party.
Well, can I know the plan?
I have to talk to my father.
Light up or fly?
It's supposed to make a little jingling sound.
Like Tinkerbell? I think you're gonna need a bigger bottle.
If she wanted us all dead, why didn't she just kill us?
Maybe it's just not how she operates. I wish we knew something about the person she was before she died.
We need a history lesson.
Yeah. As far as we know.
In all the reputable lore I've heard about the Aglaika, if she was the one to take your friend's life.
But then who killed Owen?
Her could be an actual human.
Yeah, side note from the Historical Society, we are still on the hook for the Aglaika curse.
No, but this is the problem that we are facing.
Someone with a serious grudge or someone who stood gain from his death.
Bess, do you feel comfortable talking to your families?
The cops are there. Now's a good time for us to check out Owen's apartment.
What do you mean, his room at the estate?
He had a private apartment on the other side of town. That's where he went if he wanted to get away from family or if he had a guest. Over.
Bess, are you cool handling the investigation on your end?
Yeah.
No sign of Tinkerbell?
Not everybody comes back.
I know lately you've been pummeled by life. Everything you learned about your parents and now. If you ever want to talk about anything, I'm here.
I really appreciate that. If I find the words, I will share them with you. But until then, how great is it that I can avoid talking about my two dads by avoiding talking about my dead boyfriend?
Hey, look at that. It says Marvin's storage unit on it. I don't suppose you know where the key is? Never mind. Found one.
Hey, Ace. Someone was here. Let's go.
So where are we going?
Catch a killer.
Secret compartment? Is that custom?
Yeah, Nick put it in for me when my car was in the shop. But look at that.
Don't say anything.
Exactly. As early as yesterday morning, Lucy's compass charm was in there.
If Nick built it at the garage where he worked, it would have been out in plain sight.
I think the handprint on the window wasn't... Because Owen was being watched, I think I was.
You really think he's back?
Buckle up. Would you mind waiting out here? I think I might get more out of her one-on-one.
Of course.